وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
So we take the response from the hadith of Muhammad ibn Shihab al-Zuhri. Zuhri is from the Sigar al-Tabi'in. And we took his statement previously that he said that the Sahabas, they said, كُنَّا نَقُولُ وُلِدَ اللَّيْلَةَ رَجُلٌ, that today a man was born, عَظِيمٌ, a great man, وَمَاتَ رَجُلٌ عَظِيمٌ, and a great man died. فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, the Prophet then said, فَإِنَّهَا لَا يُرْمَى بِهَا لِمَوْتِ أَحَدٍ, the shooting stars has nothing to do with the birth of a person. وَلَا لِحَيَاتِهِ, the death of somebody or the birth of somebody, has nothing to do with that. وَلَكِنْ رَبُّنَا تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَ اسْمُهُ, but Allah the Exalted, إِذَا قَضَى أَمْرًا, if He destines a matter, سَبَّحَ حَمَلَةُ الْعَرْشِ, the angels who are carrying the throne, they exalt Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ فَيَسْتَخْبِرُ بَعْضُ أَهْلُ السَّمَاءِ بَعْضًا, and so what happens? Some of the inhabitants of the sama inform others, حَتَّى يَبْلُغَ الْخَبَرُ هَذِهِ سَمَاءَ الدُّنْيَا, until the news reaches the lowest level of the sky, فَتَخْطِفُ, the jinns will snatch it. الْجِنُّ السَّمْعَ, in listening by it, they snatch it. فَيَقْذِفُونَ إِلَىٰ أَوْلِيَائِهِمْ, and they inform who? They inform their allies. So from what we take from this story is, from this narration is that the issue of the shooting stars has nothing to do with the birth or the death of anybody. وَلِذَلِكَ, the Prophet ﷺ is coming, the shooting stars was multiplied, but it didn't end at his time. وَلِذَلِكَ عُمَرَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ, and Athar Ahmad narrated in his Musnad and Ibn Hibban in his Sahih, and that Shu'ayb al-Arnaut rahimahullah agreed it to be Sahih, is that Umar said to Ghaylan ibn Salama, he said to him when he divorced his wife, إِنِّي لَأَظُنُّ الشَّيَاطِينَ, he said, I think the shayat, some of the riwayat say shaytan, and some of the riwayat say the shayateen, makes it plural. فِيمَا يَسْتَرِقُ مِنَ السَّمْعِ سَمِعَ بِمَوْتِكِ, from the things that they steal is that they heard of, they stole the information, the news pertaining to your death. فَقَذَفَهُ فِي نَفْسِكَ, and he threw it into your heart, placed it into your heart. So Umar radiallahu anhu is informing him that the hearing of the jinns will take place even after what? After the Prophet's death, alayhi salatu wasalam. But what happens is that the scholars, they confuse the coming of the jinns. The jinns, they came many times to the Prophet ﷺ, and the times that they came were different situations. وَلِذَلِكَ, one of the mistakes that Ibn Ishaq and Ibn Sa'ad fell into, which is that Ibn Ishaq mentions it in his seerah, and Ibn Sa'ad mentions in his Tabaqat al-Kubra, which is أن إسلام الجن والتقاءهم بالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو يقرأ القرآن لأول مرة كان بعد رجوعه صلى الله عليه وسلم من الطائف بعد وفاة أبي طالب وخديجة رضي الله تعالى عنهما, أما رضي الله تعالى عنها, وهذا فيه نظر. That Ibn Ishaq mentions, and Ibn Sa'ad, that the Islam of the jinns and their meeting of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم when he was reading the Quran, the first time that it occurred was after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came from what? From Taif, after having met and the death of Abu Talib. Khadija radiyallahu ta'ala anha as well. وهذا فيه نظر. Hafidh ibn Hajar, Hafidh ibn Kathir, they mentioned there's a look to this matter that Ibn Ishaq mentions and Ibn Sa'ad. So the jinns, they came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam many different times, and the hearing among the shooting stars has nothing to do with the Prophet's birth, nor is it anything to do with the Prophet's death, nor does it have anything to do with any individual. Today, inshallah ta'ala, we're going to move on to muqaddimat, introductions, things that occurred, nuzul al-wahi, when the revelation came down. Things that occurred when the revelation started. The later stages of the Prophet's days before he became a prophet, things started to occur to him, alayhi salatu wasalam. Things started to happen to him. Signs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started to give the Prophet signs. Alamat and athar. The first of them is, number one, al-ru'ya al-sadiqah. The Prophet started to see dreams that will really happen. And the revelation, the first things that the Prophet was started with, alayhi salatu wasalam, was that he would see a dream, and the dream that he would see, it will happen like a bright sunny day. كفلق الصبح. ولذلك روى الشيخان البخاري المسلم both narrated في صحيحيهما من حديث عائشة from the hadith of our mother عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها قالت she said أول ما بدأ به رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من الوحي الرؤيا الصادقة. The first thing that the Prophet was started with, I mean the first thing that happened to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام من الوحي from the revelation is الرؤيا الصادقة. The Prophet would see real dreams take place. في النوم in his sleep, فكان لا يرى رؤيا. He would not see any dreams إلا جاءت مثل except that it will occur like فلق الصبح. It will happen in the morning. حافظ الحجر سنن فتح الباري المراد بفلق الصبح ضياؤه وخص بالتشبيه لظهوره الواضح الذي لا شك فيه. That he said that the hadith mentions that the statement فلق الصبح, which means the brightness of the day. And the reason why it was said فلق الصبح is because the way that the Prophet would see the dream and its occurrence was that clear. It was like daytime, alayhi salatu wasalam. The second thing that the Prophet, a sign that happened to him was حُبُّ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. The Prophet started to love لِلْخَلْوَةِ. He loves to be alone. He wanted to be alone and not be with anybody. When the Prophet reached the age of 40, alayhi salatu wasalam, حَبَّبَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى إِلَيْهِ الْخَلْوَةِ. Allah placed in his heart the love of wanting to be alone, seclusion, and not be with anybody. فَلَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْءٌ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ أَنْ يَخْلُوَ وَحْدَهُ. It became one of the traits that he became known to do, is that to want to be alone and not to be with anybody. The Prophet ﷺ, he would leave Mecca, he would get away from Mecca every year so he could spend the month of Ramadan in Ghar al-Hira, which is now called Jabal al-Nur, which is known as Jabal al-Nur. It's a small mountain, min jibali Mecca. It's a small mountain from the mountains that are in Mecca. Hafiz Ibn Kathir, in his Kitab al-Bidayah wal-Nihayah, he talks about it more in his first volume, page 362. So the Prophet ﷺ, on the month of Ramadan, he would go into the mountain. وَكَانَ ذَلِكَ مِمَّا تَحَنَّتُ بِهِ قُرَيْشُ فِي الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ. And this was a place that before Islam, Quraysh would go there, and what they would do is they would worship Allah in that place. This was something Quraysh would do. Quraysh would go to this mountain and they would do that. So the Prophet ﷺ, it was something he used to do. Lakin here is a mas'ala, a fa'ida latifa, a very beneficial point, which is a mas'ala usuliyah that the scholars of usul al-fiqh speak about, which is هل كان قبل أن يوحى إليه متعبدا بشريعة نبي قبله. Our Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, before he became a prophet, was he worshipping Allah on a previous legislation? نبي الله محمد, before he became a prophet, was he worshipping Allah upon a previous legislation? Now I'm going to read the kalam of Hafiz ibn Hajar from his Kitab Fath al-Bari, the 9th volume, page 736. He says, رحمه الله, وهذا يلتفت أما يلتفت إلى مسألة أصولية, وهو أنه صلى الله عليه وسلم هل كان قبل أن يوحى إليه متعبدا بشريعة نبي قبله. قال الجمهور, the majority of scholars, they said لا, no, لأنه لو كان تابعا, because if the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was a follower, لستبعد أن يكون متبوعا, then it would be far-fetched for him to be one who's followed. If he was one that was following, then it would be far-fetched for him then be a leader and others follow him. وَلِأَنَّهُ لَوْ كَانَ لَنُقِلَ مَنْ كَانَ يُنْسَبُ إِلَيْهِ. And if it was the case that the Messenger was following somebody before he became a prophet, then it would have been transmitted to us, Ibn Hajar says. وَقِيلَ, and some scholars, they said, yes, he was worshipping Allah on a previous legislation. There was, some scholars, they said that. And the ones who said that, they differed amongst themselves. وَاخْتَلَفُوا فِي تَعْيِينِهِ They differed, okay, who is it that he was following? عَلَى ثَمَانِيَةِ أَقْوَالٍ Eight different views. The first of them is أَحَدُهَا آدَمُ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ The first one was, he was worshipping Allah upon the way of Adam عليه السلام. That's what some, the first group they said. والثاني, the second they said, نوح عليه السلام. The third they said, Ibrahim عليه السلام. And this, a large amount of this opinion, that this is the strongest, or the most in number. And they used the ayah of Surah Al-Nahl, the ayah of Surah Al-Nahl, ayah 123, where Allah تبارك وتعالى says to the Prophet, وَاتَّبِعْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا Follow the religion of what? أَنِ اتَّبِعْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا Follow the religion of Nabi Allah Ibrahim. وَالرَّابِعْ The second view is that he was upon the religion of Nabi Allah Musa. وَالْخَامِسُ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمْ And the fifth one is عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمْ وَالسَّادِسُ بكل شيء بلغه عن شرع نبي من الأنبياء. The sixth is that every single prophet in which it reached him, his legislation, he would do it. And the evidence that they used is the ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah, where Allah تبارك Surah Al-An'am, sorry, ayah 90, where Allah says, أولئك الذين هدى الله فبهداه مقتدي. أولئك الذين هدى الله فبهداه مقتدي. This ayah, ayah 90, Surah Al-An'am, they said, look, Allah says, after he mentioned the stories of the prophets, Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ Those who have been mentioned to you, Muhammad, Allah has guided them, subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَبِهُدَاهُ مُقْتَدِي And in their guidance, follow all Muhammad. So they said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he followed all the prophets. The seventh is that al-waqfu. They said, you know, we don't know. Yes, there was a previous legislation that he was upon and he was following, but what was it? They withheld from it. And the Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he mentions وَلَا تَخْفَى قُوَّةُ الثَّالِثِ Hafiz Ibn Hajar says, and the third one, the power in it, the strength in that one is very great. Hafiz says this rahimahullah. Now what is in the third opinion, which is that Ibrahim was the one he was told, he says that seems to be, the fact that it's the strongest, it seems to be the case. Especially the fact that the Prophet ﷺ in the issue of what? The tawaf and the sa'i, are we all together? And the hajj, a lot of it is taken from who? Nabi Ibrahim says, وَنَحْوِ ذَلِكَ مِمَّا بَقِيَ عِنْدَهُ مِنْ شَرِيعَةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ And many of the legislation of Ibrahim remained in Quraysh. They had it, a lot of his way, and that's what they used to believe. Our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يتزود لخلوته He would take provision and prepare for the times in which he would be alone. لبعض ليالي الشهر Every specific designated nights in the month in which he would prepare, he would equip himself to go what? To be alone. فَإِذَا نَفَذَ ذَلِكَ الزَّادُ Whatever provision he took with him and means if it finishes from him رَجَعَ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِهِ He would come back to his family يَتَزَوَّدُ قَدْرَ ذَلِكَ And he would then do the amount that he needed عليه الصلاة والسلام فَيُقِيمُ فِي حِرَى And he would stay in the place the mountain of حِرَى مِنْ كُلِّ سَنَةٍ Every year وَيَقْضِي وَقْتَهُ فِي التَّفْكِيرِ فِي مَا حَوْلَهُ مِنْ مَشَاهِدِ الْكَوْنِ And what he would do is The Prophet would contemplate and he would ponder on the things that were around him, the universal signs. He would ponder on them, alayhi salatu wasalam. وَفِيمَا وَرَاءَهَا مِنْ قُدْرَةٍ مُبْدِعَةٍ And he would also look at these universal signs, the things that are behind it. He would take time and do that, alayhi salatu wasalam. حَتَّى وَصَلَ مِنَ الصَّفَاءِ وَالْإِشْرَاقِ إِلَى مَرْتَبَةٍ عَالِيَةٍ إِنْعَكَسَتْ فِيهَا أَشِعَةُ الْغُيُوبِ على صفحة قلبه المجلوة فأصبح لا يرى رؤيا إلا جاءت كفلق الصبح And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam The issue became much more clearer The way that he would contemplate and ponder It would then go with him to his sleep And so when he slept he would dream And when he dreamt When he would wake up in the morning what he saw in his dream would be a reality in front of him, alayhi salatu wasalam. And I mentioned to you the famous hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, أَوَّلُ مَا بُدِئَ بِهِ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ مِنَ الْوَحِيِّ الرُّؤْيَا الصَّادِقَةَ فِي النَّوْمِ ثُمَّ حُبِّبَ إِلَيْهِ الْخَلَاءُ وَكَانَ يَخْلُو بِغَارِ حِرَى فَتَحَنَّتُ فِيهِ وَهُوَ التَّعَبُّدُ الْلَّيَالِي ذَوَاتِ الْعَدَدِ. وَكَانَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ and the Prophet also, إِذَا قَضَى جِوَارَهُ, if the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he would complete, جِوَار here means his i'tikaf, if he would finish it, مِنْ شَهْرِ ذَلِكَ كان أول ما يبتدأ به إذا انصرف قبل أن يدخل بيته الكعبة. When the Prophet ﷺ would finish his i'tikaf and the night which he would spend in Ghar al-Hira, he would come back to Mecca and the first place that he would start with is not his house, he would go to the Kaaba. He would go there. فَيَطُوفُ بِهَا سَبْعًا, he would go around the Kaaba 7 times. أو ما شاء الله تعالى من ذلك. Oh, he would do what he wanted, the amounts that he wanted, عليه الصلاة والسلام. ثُمَّ يَرْجِعُ إِلَى بَيْتِهِ, and then he would go back to his house. وَظَلَّ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, the Prophet remained that way على ثلاثة سنوات, 3 years, إلى أن جاء الوحي وهو في إحدى خلوات تلك. The Prophet was like that. The situation was for him like that. He would spend his night in Ghar al-Hira. He would remember Allah. He would ponder over what he sees. He would contemplate. This was what he became. 3 years he was doing this for. One day, from the days in which he was alone and he was there, what happened was, this is when revelation came to him. The third sign, the third thing that were introductions to the Prophet's prophecy before he became a prophet, does anyone remember the first thing that I mentioned? What was the first muqaddima? Huh? Yeah, he would see a dream and it would take place. What was the second? Khalwa, he would be alone. The third thing that was, taslimul hajari wa shajari ala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The mountain, sorry, the rocks, and the trees would greet the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-Imam Muslim narrated in his sahih min hadithi, from the hadith of Jabir ibn Samurah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Prophet said alayhi salatu wa salam, inni la'arifu hajaran bi Makkah. The Prophet said, I know a rock, a stone, a rock in Makkah, kan yusallimu alayya, that would greet me. Qabla an ub'ath, before I was sent out as a messenger and a prophet, I know a rock that was in Mecca that greeted me. Inni la arifuhu al-an, I know it until now. The Prophet said alayhi salatu wasalam. Rawahu al-Imam al-Tirmidhi narrated in his Sunan, a Hakim in his Mustadrak, bi sanad which is da'if, it's a weak narration, that Ali ibn Abi Talib said, kuntu ma'an nabiyya, I was with the Prophet, bi Makkah in Mecca. فَخَرَجْنَا فِي بَعْضِ نَوَاحِيهَا, we went to its outskirts. فَمَا اسْتَقْبَلَهُ جَبَلٌ, the Prophet didn't come into contact to a mountain. وَلَا شَجَرٌ, and a tree. إِلَّا وَهُوَ يَقُولُ, except that the Prophet was saying, السَّلَامُ عَلَيْكَ, except, sorry, the rocks were saying to the Prophet, السَّلَامُ عَلَيْكَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. It would say this. And Ibn Ishaq, he brought from some of the people of knowledge that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ibn Ishaq said, عن بعض أهل العلم أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حين أراد الله تعالى بكرامته, when Allah wanted to honor the Prophet, وابتداءه بالنبوة, and Allah wanted to start him with prophecy, كان إذا خرج لحاجته أبعد حتى تحسر. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he would go far, he would leave, خرج لحاجته, if he came out to do his call of nature, أبعد, he would go as far, حتى تحسر, ببعد تحسر, أي انكشف. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he would go as far, حتى تحسر عنه البيوت, until the houses would hide him, عليه الصلاة والسلام, ويفضي إلى شعاب. And he صلى الله عليه وسلم, he would go towards Shi'ab, are valleys between mountains, the roads between mountains. Mimakkata wa butuni awdiyatiha, and its valleys. فَلَا يَمُرُّ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ بِحَجَرٍ, the Prophet wouldn't go by a rock, وَلَا شَجَرٍ, or a tree, إِلَّا قَالَ, except that it said to him, السَّلَامُ عَلَيْكَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, it would greet the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. الإمام السهيلي in his روضة الأنف, He mentions that these greetings, were they literal or were they metaphorical? He says, وَهَذَا التَّسْلِيمُ الْأَظْهَرُ فِيهِ أَنْ يَكُونَ حَقِيقَةً وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَىٰ أَنْطَقَهُ إِنْطَاقًا كَمَا خَلَقَ الْحَنِينَ فِي الْجِدْعِ. He says that it was literal, that Allah made them speak to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Just like the rock, just like the tree cried when the Prophet ﷺ moved from it. Remember when he moved from the, he used to do khutbah there, and the Prophet moved from it, it cried, and it made a crying noise. So the Lord that made it speak is the Lord that made it silent. So it wouldn't be anything for him subhanahu wa ta'ala to do so. Not to mention the hadith is in what? The hadith is in Sahih Muslim. For us, Bukhari and Muslim are what? The most authentic book. Iraqi says, وَأَوَّلُ مَنْ أَلَّفَ فِي وَأَوَّلُ مَنْ صَنَّفَ فِي الصَّحِيحِ مُحَمَّدٌ وَخُصَّتْ بِالتَّرْجِيحِ وَمُسْلِمٌ بَعْدُ وَبَعْضُ الْغَرْبِ مَعْ أَبِي عَلِيٍّ فَضَّلُوا ذَا لَوْ نَفَعْ وَلَمْ يَعُمَّاهُ وَلَكِنْ قَلَّمَا عِنْدَ ابْنِ الْأَخْرَمِ مِنْهُ قَدْ فَاتَهُمَا وَرُدَّ لَكِنْ قَالَ يَحْيَى الْبَرُّ لَمْ يَفُتْ الْخَمْسَةَ إِلَّا النَّزْرُ وَفِيهِمَا فِيهِ لِقَوْلِ الْجُعْفِي أَحْفَظُ مِنْ 10,000 ألف. The Bukhari is the most authentic book. And then which one comes next? The Muslim. So the hadith in Bukhari and Muslim are what? They are authentic. The overall hadith in Bukhari and Muslim are authentic. So sometimes the disbelievers will bring doubt to you regarding these things. I'll try to bring shubuhat to you. This argument of whether the rock spoke or not is a fara' of do you believe Allah tabarak wa ta'ala awwalan? Sah? Because those who believe in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala believe in miracles. Sah? They believe in it. Like an atheist who doesn't believe in Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's existence. Talking to him about the Prophet ﷺ took a burraq, the night of Isra' al-Mi'raj. Sah? That will make sense to him. That will make sense to him at all. So the first discussion is, before we speak about miracles, we speak about Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's existence. The Prophet ﷺ, he stayed like that. That was the third sign of his prophecy. Things like that were happening around him. The fourth thing is سَمَاعُ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ الصَّوْتِ. The Prophet hears noise. وَرُؤْيَتُهُ الضَّوْءَ. And he's seeing صلى الله عليه وسلم the ضوء. What does this mean? An Imam Muslim narrated in his Sahih عن Ibn Abbas, from Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله تعالى عنهما. He said, أَقَامَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he stayed in what? He stayed in Mecca 15 years. 15 years. يَسْمَعُ الصَّوْتَ. He would hear noises, sound. وَيَرَى الضَّوْءَ. And he would see صلى الله عليه وسلم الضوء. What does ضوء mean? Al-Qadhi Iyad in the Sharh Sahih Muslim, he says, أي صوت الهاتف به من الملائكة. He would hear the noise of angel. وَيَرَى الضَّوْءَ أي نُورُ الْمَلَائِكَ. And he would see the light of the angel. وَنُورُ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ. And he would see the signs, the light of what? Of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Nur, the light of Allah's signs subhanahu wa ta'ala. حَتَّى رَأَى الْمَلِكَ بِعَيْنِ. Until he saw the angel with his own eyes. وَشَافَهُ بِوَحْيِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. And he spoke to him with the revelation. So this is what the Prophet started to see عليه الصلاة والسلام. The angels. Ibn Abbas also narrated, as Imam Ahmad narrated his Musnad ala Sharti Muslimin, that Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to Khadija, إِنِّي أَرَى ضَوْءًا. I see light. وَأَسْمَعُ صَوْتًا. And I hear noise, sound. وَإِنِّي أَخْشَ أَن يَكُونَ بِي جُنُن. And I am scared that this is, that I've come to become crazy. A junoon, I've become a crazy person. فَقَالَتْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهَا. Our mother, Khadija, she said to him, لَمْ يَكُنِ اللَّهُ لِيَفْعَلَ ذَلِكَ بِكَ يَبْنَ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ. She said, Allah is not one to do that to you, the son of Abdullah. ثُمَّ أَتَتْ وَرَقَةَ بْنُ نَوْفَلٍ. Then she took him to وَرَقَةَ بْنُ نَوْفَلٍ. فَذَكَرَتْ ذَلِكَ لَهُ. She told him this. فَقَالَ, he said, إِنْ يَقُوا صَادِقًا. If what this man is saying, Nabi Muhammad, is truthful, فَإِنَّ هَذَا نَامُوسٌ. This is نَامُوس. نَامُوس means صاحب السر الخير. It's a person who has the secret of good. And before they used to call the Namus a Jibreel. That's the name they knew of Jibreel. And Jibreel, the reason why they called him Namus is because he held the secret, which is the revelation. صح? Jibreel's job was to keep the revelation. إِن يَقُوا صَادِقًا, if he's truthful, فَإِنَّ هَذَا نَامُوسٌ, this is the Jibreel, مِثْلُ like نَامُوسِ مُوسَى, it's like the Jibreel that came to Musa. فَإِن بُعِثَ وَأَنَا حَيٌّ, if this man, Nabi Allah Muhammad, is sent out and I'm alive at that time, فَسَأُعَزِّزُهُ, when I'm going to what? فَأُعَزِّرُهُ, sorry, I will give him help and aid, and I would support him in his cause and his efforts. Ta'zir, it means here al-i'ana, aid and support. And I'm going to give him tawqir, I'm going to honor him, venerate him. And I'm going to give him al-nasr, marratan ba'da marra. That's what the word means. Sa'u'azziruhu wa ansuruhu wa u'minu bihi, and I will believe in him. But they say Waraqa died. Some of the ulama actually did say that Waraqa is a believer, from the believers of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Some of the scholars said that. Now we're going to go into the events that took place, min nuzul al-wahy, from the events that happened from the revelation coming down until the migration of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam to Medina. The revelation coming down on the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam reached 40 years of age, and he went out to Ghar Hira, as we mentioned. كَمَا كَانَ يَخْرُجُ فِي شَهْرِ رَمَضَانِ, as he would always do in Ramadan. The Prophet, every Ramadan, he would go out there. That was part of his schedule. Jibreel came to him on one of the events. On one of the occasions that he used to do this, Jibreel came down on him. بِأَمْرِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ, with the command of Allah. وَبَعَثَهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, Nabi Allah Muhammad was sent out as a what? Mercy to mankind. وَكَافَةً لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَذِيرًا, and he was sent out to all of mankind as one that brings good news and glad tidings, and one that warns the people of a punishment that awaits them if they go against Allah Ta'ala's command. Bukhari narrated in his Sahih on the authority of Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, that he said, بُعِثَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ لِأَرْبَعِينَ سَنَةً, the Prophet was 40 years of age. Allah sent him out as a messenger. فَمَكَّثَ بِمَكَّةً, the Prophet remained. فَمَكَثَ بِمَكَّةً, he stayed in Mecca. 13 سنة, 13 years he stayed in Mecca. يوحى إليه, revelation was being sent on him. ثم أمر, and then he was commanded بالهجرة, to migrate. فهاجر 10 سنين, and then he went to what? He went to Medina, stayed there for 10 years. ومات, and he died. وهو ابن 63 سنة, the Prophet died at the age of 63. We're now going to go into the Prophet's life as a prophet now. All of that which we spoke about for the last couple of months, the last 5-6 months that we've been doing the seerah, was all before the Prophet was born. Now we're going to go into the Prophet's birth. The scholars, ya ikhwa, they divide the Prophet's life and they categorize it into two. The life of the Prophet is categorized into two. First one is what is known as the Meccan period, where the Prophet ﷺ, he stayed in Mecca, he was a resident in Mecca, and he lived in Mecca. And the second is the Medinian period, which is when the Prophet migrated to what? When he migrated to Medina. The Medinian period, sorry, the Meccan period, the scholars, they categorize it into what? They categorize it into three, the Meccan period. They categorize it into what? Into three. The first of it is what? When the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was made into a prophet, and he just became a what? A prophet. Okay? The second, the time when the da'wah was made private, it wasn't made public and open, it was told to make it private. And the second one was when he was told to go out and to call to the message and propagate it. And the third is that when the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam was told to go outside Mecca, he didn't migrate yet, but he went Ta'if. So he didn't just speak to the people of Mecca, he actually went out to the neighboring cities of Mecca and talked to other tribes other than Quraysh. Are we all together? Those are the three main categories we can divide the Prophet's life in Mecca, inshallah ta'ala. How many years did the Prophet stay in Mecca? He stayed there for 13 years. Alayhi salatu wa salam. And he stayed in Medina for how many years? For 10 years. And he became a Prophet when he was at what age? 40. So he died at what age? He became a Prophet when he was 40. He died at what age? Alayhi salatu wa salam. At 63 years of age. And Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah, he said, وَالصَّحِيحُ أَنَّهُ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ بُعِثَ عَلَىٰ رَأْسِ الْأَرْبَعِينَ سَنَةً. What is authentic and correct, because there are other views, is that the Prophet became a Prophet at the age of 40. هَذَا هُوَ الْمَشْهُورُ الَّذِي أَطْبَقَ عَلَيْهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. This is the view that the scholars have mentioned, and overwhelming majority of them have mentioned. This is the kalam of Imam al-Nawawi in Sharh Sahih Muslim. Ibn al-Qayyim says, in his great book Zad al-Mi'ad, he says, فَلَمَّا كَمُولَ لَهُ أَرْبَعُونَ. When 40 became complete for him, meaning he became 40, أَشْرَقَ عَلَيْهِ نُورُ النُّبُوَّةِ. The light of prophecy was split for him. وَأَكْرَمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى بِرِسَالَتِهِ. And Allah honored him to giving him the message. وَبَعَثَهُ إِلَىٰ خَلْقِهِ. And Allah sent him to his people, the creation. وَاخْتَصَّهُ بِكَرَامَتِهِ وَجَعَلَهُ أَمِينَهُ بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَ عِبَادِهِ. And Allah made the Prophet the one who is between the creation and the Creator, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So what year was he when he became a Prophet? As we mentioned, he was what? 40. Also, Jamaluddin Abu Zakaria Yahya ibn Sharaf, Yahya ibn Yusuf al-Sarsari rahimahullah, he mentions, rahimahullah, he says, وَأَتَتْ عَلَيْهِ أَرْبَعُونَ أَشْرَقَتْ شَمْسُ النُّبُوَّةِ مِنْهُ فِي رَمَضَانِ. 40 years of age came to him, and this is when Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he bestowed upon him, Allah gave him subhanahu wa ta'ala the light of prophecy in the month of Ramadan. So we learned two things. He became a prophet at what age? 40. And what time of the year did he become a prophet? In the month of Ramadan, alayhi salatu wasalam. And what day was it? وَكَانَ ذَلِكَ يَوْمَ الْإِثْنَيْنِ. It was on a Monday. السابع عشر من رمضان. It was on the 17th of Ramadan. And the evidence for that is the statement of Allah. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. That the Quran was sent down as guidance to mankind. But Allah mentions in the ayah, شهر رمضان. In the month of Ramadan, الذي أنزل فيه القرآن, which the Quran was sent down. And it was sent down as what? Hudan, guidance. للناس, for the people. وبينات, it was also sent as a clarity and to clarify for the people. من الهدى والفرقان, to clarify for the people and to be clear to the people in terms of guidance and in terms of distinguishing what is right from what is wrong. The evidence that it was on a Monday was that Muslim narrated in his Sahih on the authority of what? The noble companion Abi Qatada. He said that the Prophet ﷺ has said, when he was asked about the fasting on Monday, he said, "Fihi wulitu." I fast on Monday because I was born. وَفِيهِ أُنزِلَ عَلَيَّ. And on that day, the revelation was sent on me. It was on a Monday. We're going to, inshallah ta'ala, listen to, and we're going to now mention the hadith of our mother, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, in which she speaks about the story of how it happened that the Prophet became a prophet. We should leave that for now, inshallah ta'ala, and inshallah take some questions and answers, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. So I'll conclude there, bi'idhnillahi there. Anything which I have said that was wrong and incorrect is from me, shaitan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from me. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.